Okay, students, this is the first question of this session. Okay, try to attend till last. Try to attend till last so that it should be helpful to you. Understood? It is not some entertaining that 1 or 2 minutes attending will make you eligible and you will get the seat in IIT. Patience is required. Okay. So, first of all, let us start with the a vessel contains helium gas at 220 atm. Okay. Vessel contains helium gas at 20 atm and methane gas is at some other atm. Okay. PATM. When a pinhole is made in the vessel, the gas is coming out initially contains 80%. 80%. Okay. There is a formula for how much number of moles ratio coming out. There is a formula. Use that formula. You have to find out P. Option A 2.5, option B 10 ATM, option C 40 ATM, option D 1 ATM. My sincere suggestion is don't skip this time exam. This time you will find little competition. Okay. Why it is that I will tell you afterwards. First solve this question. Okay. Okay, at least I am giving you formula so that you can find out R1 by R2 is equal to square root, for the pressure there won't be square root, okay, and it is proportional, rate of diffusion is directly proportional, but inverse proportional I think everybody know with the molecular mass or density, vapor density, okay. So, answer the vapor density. Here it is R2, then it will be M2. Here it is R1, this will be M1. Okay. So, this is the formula. Let us take helium gas. This is helium, this is helium, and this is helium. Okay. So, this will be for the unknown gas, methane, and methane. Understood? Here, percentage of helium can be taken as rate of diffusion. Understood? So, this will be 80 by remaining 20 will be here. Rate of diffusion of helium is 80% and 20%. Pressure of helium is given as how much? I will write it here. Here you will write how much? 20 atm. This is what the question. Molecular mass of helium will be 16. This will be 4. Okay. On simplification, you will get formula, I think, is it understood? Note of this formula, it will be useful. R helium divided by R, or R1 by R2 is equal to 1 and 1 will be here. Inversely with square root will be with molecular mass. Now tell me the answer. Answer you will get, I think, B option. B option you are getting or not? Okay, good. Procedure understood? So, like this states of matter question will be there. So, be careful. Okay. Okay. Next question. This is a more than one correct question. So, try to think in all aspects. Reaction with here. See, physical state is very important. Reaction with A solid reversible with 2B gas. Okay. Is in equilibrium at 4 ATM at 27 degrees Celsius. Then what happened according to Nichiren's principle? Equilibrium is disturbed. Okay. So, but disturbance is done by the help of the volume of system is increased and kept temperature constant. Once temperature is constant, equilibrium constant is going to be constant because equilibrium constant will be constant at constant temperature. Okay. Then at new equilibrium, after re-establishing the equilibrium, what will be with respect to initial? Initially comparing moles of A decreases, moles of B increases, molar concentration of A decreases, molar concentration of B decreases. Okay. See here, the very most students have a doubt that solid concentration will not change, but it is not about the solid or liquid, it is about the moles. Okay, See, simply when 4 atm volume of system increased, that means pressure is decreased. What is decreased? Volume increased means pressure is decreased. Once pressure is decreased, equilibrium will shift in forward direction. Will shift in the forward direction. More number of moles. So more number of moles will be here 2 moles of gas. And while counting the moles, you should only for guessing the, only for identifying the direction, you should see the gaseous moles, but not everything. Is it understood? So once it is going in this direction, so most of the people will not select this answer because their teachers are, they may be having in mind that solid you need not to count. Solid concentration you need not to count, but solid moles you need to count. Is it understood? There is no change in concentration. Okay. Because moles will decrease, volume will increase. So accordingly, there is no term in the KC value. Okay. So therefore, moles of the A, if it is going in the forward direction, obviously A will be consumed. Therefore, moles of A will be decreasing. Okay. And moles of B also will increase. Understood? And there was previous advanced question. How many times it will increase? How many times it will decrease? So, by constant temperature, Kc will be what? Constant. So, suppose if it is decreases by 2 times, it will increase by, its concentration will increase by 2 to the power of 2 times. Okay, because square it is there. Is that understood? So, accordingly, you have to select that value. Understood? So B answer also correct. B answer also correct. Okay, see here, moles of B will increase. Is it understood? Why moles of B? And there is no concentration change because once you say Kc is constant, okay? Kc is constant, therefore this ratio must be, concentration must be constant. Rate of forward reaction will be same. Rate of backward reaction will be same. Therefore, Kc will be same. Kc is same, therefore concentration will be remaining same. Okay? Is that understood? Okay, next question is from solid state. These type of questions, if you feel that you will be able to answer on your own, you will be able to understand from the solution, then it is very difficult. Because this type of special is solid state three-dimensional concept, you need to understand with proper explanation. Then only you will be able to understand. Okay. So let's see the question. And potassium crystallizes in BCC lattice with cell length of A. Okay. Which are correct statements? Simple BCC lattice. Mainly you should understand that it is element, not compound. Okay, compound there will be different answer, element there will be different answer. Potassium crystallizing, not potassium chloride. Okay, so along first option is along one body's diagonal, effectively 1.25 atoms. Along one phase diagonal, effectiveness. So for this only I have specially made contribution. Okay. There is a, in solid state you can go through the 3D. From the starting there are 3D lectures in the solid state. Okay. And you will find contribution. How to calculate contribution with tricks and tips I have uploaded in the solid state. So this was possible because of the YouTube only, because animations can be shown, these cannot be shown in the classroom or on a plain board. Okay, so along 1.25 atoms present per unit cell. Next, along one phase diagonal, effectively one atom is present per unit cell. Then R is the radius of atom, then 4A is equal to root 3R. And coordination number C, this is very important, topmost layer. Okay, everybody knows that coordination number of BCC. Don't neglect a single word. Okay. Let us see who will answer correct and accurate answer. It is more than one correct option. See, after repeatedly telling this is topmost layer, what is difference between topmost layer and here you have to be, see, actually advance is only about the presence of mind, attitude to do something in different manner. Okay. If you think very nicely, there is answer is A and B only. Okay. How it can be, see, 4R is equal to root 3A. Here, why it is wrong, is it understood? 4R is equal to root 3A. And in topmost layer, coordination number will be only 6. Sorry, only 4. Topmost layer. Okay. So, here what you will see in the normal, if it is simply mentioned in BCC, coordination number is 8. Okay. In topmost layer, only top atoms will be considered as neighbors. Understood? So that's why topmost layer coordination number is not 8. This is wrong. Okay. Now see, along body diagonal, effective atoms are 1.25. How it is, body center will be completely inside that. Okay. And both corners, one eighth of the part will be inside the center. That is 1/8 means 0.125, I think. 0.125 into 2. Two corners will be along the body diagonal. Is it understood? That's why effectively how much it is present? 1.25 atoms will be present per unit cell. Okay. Same way, phase diagonal, why it is reduced to one atom? Because in the phase diagonal, that half only will be inside the unit cell. Here body center will be completely inside the unit cell, but phase center only half will be inside the, therefore half will be reduced. Understood? But problem is that it will be in the phase, when you consider about the phase, the corner contribution within the unit cell will be increasing. Okay. So therefore, finally, we'll get answer of one atom. Okay. Why A and B correct? Why C and D not correct? Is that clear to all of you? Here it should be interchanged. Here, if this not is there, it is not there, then answer is correct. Okay. Is that clear? Shall we go for next such questions? Okay. Here, this is the comprehension compounds of transition element. Compounds of transition and inner transition elements are colored, and color may be due to DD transfer, FF transfer, charge transfer, and fourth one is polarization. Okay. So people started answering, but it is not question. Okay. It is the comprehension. Now, based on this is a knowledge given to you. Based on this, the questions will start. Okay. So here all points are correct according to the comprehension. Understood? What you will do, you will remember all these four properties. That here transition will be DD transition, inner transition will be FF transition. Okay? And potassium dichromate, like them, charge transfer. Okay? In some places MnO2, like that, polarization. These are the four reasons because of which they are colored. This information is given to you. Based on this information, now questions is about to come. Okay. Ready for the questions? Okay. Question is here. Based upon that, now question will be here. COH2O4+2 is blue color. Then COH2O6 will be same blue color, because same cobalt plus same oxidation number are colorless, are white, are pink. See here, I will tell you, actually this is due to DD transition. What answer? Due to DD transition. Four reasons already given in the comprehension. When your option will be DD transition in the coordinate compounds, option will be DD transition. But here that answer, how it can be used to solve this one. Okay. So here it is tetrahedral delta T and here it is delta O. In the coordinate compounds, you got this relation or not? Which is more, delta T or delta O? delta t is more or delta o is more? How I could come to know this is o, this is t? 6 means octahedral, 4 means tetrahedral. Is that clear? So this is more, understood? So once it is more, delta is equal to hc upon lambda o, hc upon lambda t. Is that clear to all of you? So this is less means this t will be more, this t o will be less. Okay. Now once he says that it is colored, so unpaired electrons are there. So once unpaired electrons are there, this cannot be colorless. And once wavelength absorbing is changing, it cannot be blue. And in chemistry, colorless and white is same. So answer will be pink. Is that approach clear? How link up questions will be there? Do you think that solving by the PDF, going through the solved questions, will you be able to get this much information and approach? Do you agree with that? No. Okay, so that's why going through the video solution selected questions during the last moment is very, very essential. So spend some quality time during this crash course. Okay. Okay, next question is, if a trivalent lanthanoid has electronic configuration of 4F4, then which of the following will have same color? Okay. So try to answer carefully. If the answer is in the comprehension. Okay, answer to this question is F10. What is the answer? F10. Same number of unpaired, same will be the color. Write down rule. Same number of unpaired, same will be the color. Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. So if I write F4, four unpaired, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, four unpaired. So same number of unpaired, same will be the number of unpaired electron. Therefore, same will be the color. Okay. So there may be some shortcuts people will make, like 14 minus X should be is equal to X. Okay, so shortcut you remember or concept you remember, it is up to you. Okay, whenever 14 minus X is equal to X, then color will be same. Okay. Read the question carefully. Both AgBr and AgIr yellow colored. Okay, AGI is intense colored and pale yellow is AGBR. The reason is, okay, four option, more polarizing power of Ag positive, more polarized ability, ability for I minus, ability for Br minus is more, and both A and B are correct. Okay. See, people start answering by guessing because they have a strong feeling that fourth options with more than one option will be definitely correct, but it is not. Answer is what? B option. Okay. See, you more or less will be coming when this is changing in both of them, Ag plus, Ag plus. Metal is same, metal charge is also same. So how it can be more polarizing power in one and less polarizing power in other? Okay. Polarizing power depends on charge on what? Cation and size of the cation. Both ways, size and charge are same. So we cannot compare the, we cannot say more or less in both of them. And iodine minus is large in size, so polarizability will be more. So answer will be B option. What is answer? Only B option. Okay, more polarizability of I minus, therefore more will be the intensity of yellow color. Okay, next question. KMnO4 is colored due to DD transition, FF transition, polarization, charge transfer. Very simple question. Those who know, for them it is very simple. Answer is D. Okay. So when you will, if it is a coordinate compound with the D block element, answer will be DD transition. If it is a coordinate compound with F block element, answer will be FF transition. AGBR, AGI example I have given, there it will be polarization. And anything with the not following this condition, okay? And no unpaired electron. Unpaired electron is there, then definitely reason is going to be unpaired. In a manganese here, less 7 oxidation number, no unpaired, but still it is colored, then reason will be charge transfer. So answer to this question is charge transfer. Okay, next is oxidation number of chromium in K3CrO8. Is option A plus 3, option B plus 2, option C plus 6, option D plus 5. Okay, this answer to this question is D plus 5. Okay, and this was previous mains question. Okay, that time some people call it as a AAAA also, but this time I am expecting somewhat improved question. Write down in K3CrO8, four peroxide ions, four peroxide ion, okay. So accordingly, their question may be changed. Understood? Okay, next question is number of moles of KMnO4 react completely with 1 mole of ferrous oxalate in acidic medium. Okay, so let's see who will answer fast. See here, every word is important in acidic medium. Okay, Mn plus 7 is going to convert as Mn plus 2. So 5 electrons. Is that understood? It requires 5 electrons. Here I will write 5 electrons. Okay. Now here see, ferrous, every word very, very carefully, oxalate. Okay. Ferrous Fe plus 2 and C2O4 2 minus. Is converted into Fe plus 3 plus 2 CO2. Okay. So from here to here, 1 electron, and here it is plus 3 to plus 4. So 2 electrons. Understood? So what should here it requires total how many? 3 electron it can liberate, but it require 5 electron. So answer will be 3 by 5. What will be the answer? Why 3 by 5 is it understood? In C2O4 2 minus oxidation number is plus 3 and it is converted to C2O4, so plus 4 and 2 carbon. This part very important. If it is written here, then don't worry. If it is here, then you should worry. 2 into 1, that is 2. And for iron, 1 electron. Total number of electrons are how many? 3. So 3 electron and 5 electrons. So per 1 mole, it will be 3 by 5. Okay.